Yeah, Smart War Games here. I got two more games for a content review before we will make a break. This time we will review English Civil War by HOD. Many of those HOD games are on Steam, but there are a couple that are not for whatever reason, which is a shame because there's not really many wars. Not many war games covering the English Civil War, especially from a serious perspective. So I think it is worth to check it out. It's normally also not running on the highest price, but especially now on the holiday sales, it is even more worth. Acquired a game, I installed it on modern operating systems, no problem. Yeah, make sure that you get the update. And then you're good to go. You might want to adjust your settings, but I run it with default settings and it was fine. In order to show you the manual, it is 143 pages . This looks good. If you're already familiar with HOD games, you should be fine. But here you might also read about the specifics of this war, in case you're not educated on it. There's even a timeline. That is great. Might read that in order to gain a quick idea on how the English Civil War proceeded. And then some hotkeys and some icon explanations. Okay. Yeah, let's start the game. I'm currently running 1920 by 1080. Most of those HOD games also work in higher resolution, but keep in mind that the font, everything will become smaller, and I think 1920 is already quite small, perhaps for some gamers with not the best eyesight, already too small, then of course lower the resolution. But yeah, 1920 looks okay. Yeah, you have some settings here, just show them you where you can modify the AI. I usually leave everything on default. I read something about the people modifying those settings. For example, yeah, good AI setting, but there's also, okay, here not. There was sometimes in some HOD games, there's a slider to set how much processing time you want to give the AI, and there were some HOD veterans conducting tests and didn't really notice a big difference. Good. So the game comes with three tutorial scenarios, as many of those HOD games come with, in order to bring you update you on the basics. They are guided by written text boxes, so check them out. They might also come with the specifics of this game. And then you have two scenarios that start at a specific point of the war, and you have the entire thing. And we might want to check that out, and then I might play, I think, the 45 when I test it out a bit. And yeah, you can pick both sides, and you can play also EBM, that should be possible. Was in the options menu if you start the game. Okay, you have a small introduction. And then you're presented this interface. So map looks quite nice. And yeah, there are not really many games focusing on this topic, so this might be indeed your best choice for it. You have, yeah, text filters. That is basically where you receive new messages, etc., which you can filter. Well, we have two messages here. You click here, and you see it is already a bit small. I mean, I can still read it, but you might want to lower it to something 1600-ish. Or if you want it bigger, lower it to 1300, whatever. Yeah, there's those two messages we received. And then you have some map filters, also similar to other HOD games, which you can open here. I guess helpful one is, of course, the political one, which gives you quickly an idea what regions belong to whom. But you can also check for supply, etc., in order not to get cut off with your armies. And weather, etc. Stick with the ownership. Good. This our army. Yeah, and else you have, you can switch into recruitment mode. If you select a unit, you can see where you can recruit it. Currently, we can't recruit. Perhaps we can in this region. Normally, red means no. Yeah, okay. But later on, this will definitely become a thing, and then you can recruit your selector unit. Usually, the region where you might do that highlights. Then there's, as in many HOD games, a decision. You see this highlighting here, indicating that is something you can use in a specific region. And that gives a nice flavor to the game. Yeah, that is basically cards. Here's the number of the cards you own. Usually you need to pay us something for them, or you need to use them, keep them for perhaps when the time is right. You can't check them, but need to read the pop-up box. The text is slightly small, definitely. I would recommend play this on something 1600. Or whatever is suiting you. For example, we could play commission. And it will give us some infantry volunteers. We have 6 cards of that. That is, of course, something you might want to play in order to get quickly bolster your forces up. And you see this icon indicating where you're playing those. But sure, if somebody meanwhile overruns those positions, this might be wasted. Yeah, you can play also multiple cards. That is decision mode. And then you have the strategic atlas, that is basically your empire management screen, where you can check your forces. That is also, I guess, beside España 36. If you simply like this type of game, but you think some of those games are too complex, too big, and think your civil British or English civil war is interesting, you might want to check this game out, because it is, of course, involving not that much forces compared to other wars. For example, right now we have not that much units, but the war is basically starting. Of course, this will become more and more. We have basically one fleet and two armies, or two stacks. Yeah, production is a thing once you start training. That is something military information or decisions you can make. As for the government, currently there's nothing. Religious affair, that is of course important as well in this war. Foreign affairs might become available. A strategic map with some filters. Tracking regions. And what is going on there, how much military control do you have, and how loyal are they, and how what they are producing. Your strategic objectives. And yeah, some basic information of the status quo and some background. Good, that is currently our capital. There is also an army sitting in here, right? Or not, no. Good, Lindsay, that is Lindsay's force currently not able to move by this red band or whatever. For one turn, they are not allowed to move. And my second army is sitting here. Ah, yeah, okay. They are also not allowed to move. Good, but I might play the other scenario because then I can quickly show combat and we talk about this. But that is a grand campaign, and this, you see, it is starting with very low unit, so unit amounts, you have basically one fleet, two armies, and then it gets bigger and bigger. The AO is of course somewhat limited. So if you ever looked for a good introduction game into HOD or into grand strategy in general, check this out. And performance-wise, it is fine. Yeah, sometimes but I guess you can do it with auto hotkey or something. Having WASD controls by bringing over the arrow keys to the WASD. Good, let's check out the 45 scenario because that is which I trained a bit. You know, to be ready for this video. Not an expert on this game, of course, but I will show you a bit around so that you gain an idea. Because we are already here conducting a siege. And yeah, about unit management, sometimes those HOD games receive criticism for being UI-wise or usability-wise not that great. I don't know, it can become sometimes convoluted if you move a lot of units around, like in Napoleonic Warfare or Civil War battles, because they often duplicate like this. See where the unit is coming from, and the blinking is indicating the destination, which you then can move around, create also waypoints, and also remove them again. But once you figure that out, you might think even that it's not that bad. Sure, if you have a lot of armies, then it can get quite crowded. And it's not one of those games where you move and engage immediately. It is, I think, more authentic. You move into the regions, but doesn't mean that two armies will engage each other. It also doesn't mean that they will immediately destroy each other. You can set stances here. Currently we are on a defensive posture. But we want to siege this fortress here. On the other hand, defensive posture is fine, yeah, but perhaps you want to push it a bit. You can also go all in, but as you might know, assaulting fortress and something can be extremely costly, and even 1/10 or even lower of a force can hold off an army from a fortress. So we will stick here. And yeah, here you have the special orders. Sometimes you can do stuff. Currently we don't have nothing here to do, but it is. So let's switch to defend. No, hold it at all costs, not. You can also do defend and retreat. If the army encounters an enemy, especially if it is stronger, they will try to delay it. Or you can set them to disengage. For example, if you have some units that rather do screening, and you set them to retreat, and they will try to get away. Might sometimes not work out, of course. But for example, for calf units, that is a good setting. Yeah, if you do assault posture, they might assault the fortress. That is a bit too aggressive, but perhaps we want to do that in order to show you how it looks. Yeah. But currently, we can't do it anyways. Sometimes it is not possible because of command reasons or whatever. Yeah, managing units, I think it is quite good. For example, if you want to create a new unit with Leslie, simply pull this guy out and position him here. And then you can switch units around. I think that is pretty good. Not many war games have that. It's that easy to create armies. And if you're not agreeing, you put him back. That's how you can do it. That is quite good. Ah, we are not even... Wait. No, we are here in the region, okay. Yeah, let's see if we can find some combat, so I can show you combat. But perhaps you have already seen it in other videos. Combat is, I think, quite detailed, but you don't not required to watch it or to... But the detail that is accessible is quite deep. Let's see, perhaps here we can trigger a combat. But this guy is us sitting in a castle. Those guys sitting somewhere in the castle, not coming out anymore. There's a royalist force outside here. Ah, look at this. Right. But this guy is currently not available for one turn. Okay, so perhaps next turn we will see some combat. Meanwhile, I might move. Let's just quickly check supply, because the English Civil War was, of course, quite convoluted, yeah. There's no clear front lines like in World War I or II. You always need to check your supplies. And if you don't have a good supply situation, you might want to build a supply depot. Yeah, that looks good. But challenging for those guys here. So let's besiege them. And here perhaps we then can pull off our assault posture, because this guy is... Do we want to do an all-out attack just for the video? Yeah, we can also switch back to the normal map. Perhaps with this time you don't need the overlay. Map is quite nice looking. And sooner or later you can tell by the flags and simply by the situation what is going on. I mean, you also see those little shields here which indicate who is owning them. Good. We have... Yeah, one thing that I also really like about this game, if you click on this icon here, on the tactical icon, you will get information. Yeah, and this game is coming with deep information. Yeah, some HOD games don't have that. But here, if you want to know more about a commander, you hover over it and will get information. I think they have quite detailed values. It is not only, I don't know, attack, defense, but it's quite deeper. Sure, in a greater picture might not make that big of a difference. On the other hand, here perhaps more because you have less units, but it is still great that you have this detail under the hood. I often think alone the presence of that is already making a game more enjoyable. Imagine you play a game and you know only there's only two or three values that are calculated, or you have a game where everything matters, even if it is only 0.1%. Yeah, and same for the units, you can click on a unit, get some information. It won't explain you exactly what those guys do, but you could guess. Yeah. Pikeman. Good. Let's move and siege. Perhaps immediate assault. With this stance, they might attack. But there's quite a lot sitting here, it seems. But it's sometimes the leader on its own decides if he will do it or not. We will see if they go for my suicidal orders. Yeah, I really like the map. It looks modern. It looks, you don't have to feel that it's an aged game. Somehow, I don't know, I think if, when I played my first HOD game, I was thinking, yeah, that is quite a strange interface. But the more you play it, the more you value it somehow. I don't know. Because it's something similar to Combat Mission. If you see the first time Combat Mission interface, you think, what the heck? I mean, sure, it is of course not perfect. But with the time, you not notice it anymore. And I really like those drag and drop mechanics. I'm not a fan of pressing a lot of stuff on the keyboard or hitting millions of switches. Especially army management, splitting, merging can sometimes be quite a nuisance in war games, but here it is no problem. Okay, I think that's it. I mean, we can check our cards and recruitment. Yes, we have something to recruit here. That for a guy. Levy infantry. Yeah, those guys look as if they are definitely not volunteers. Or perhaps are they? They look like. Okay, let's see. An RT is not possible. Somewhere. Yeah, the only thing we can draft is some poor infantry, but better than nothing. I mean, we have nothing here at Glasgow. Okay, at Glasgow somebody is sitting. At Edinburgh, nobody, so let's recruit a unit there. Okay, that's it. Those are white. White normally indicates. Ah, look at this. There's some regions where we can recruit. Let's check our. Okay, we have 34 war supplies and 2,800 pounds. Not sure if that is much. So if you run out, you need to watch out, of course, with recruitment. Okay, here in this region, let's see. Do we have here already something? We have some calf sitting around here. That's it. One unit. And here's another army. Music is quite good. Perhaps I'll make it a bit louder. There's a sound lever in the game, but it is one of those sound levers. Level 1 is ultra loud, level 0 is mute. That is us in those HOD games, sometimes the sound levers are quite not very sensitive. Yeah, let's get some, but cannons sitting alone is also not a good idea. Yeah, here, pikemen. Let's, London is, I guess, quite important. Ah, look at this, we're running out of supplies. But okay, that's it. Yeah, everything turned red. That's a nice feature, yeah. Everything turns red and you immediately know, okay, don't need to look. Let's check decision mode. Do we want to engage into plunder? That was a thing back then. But plunder around here, it's very besieging. Okay, we are moving here, and where was the other army that was sitting basically? Ah, here. But no plunder here, okay. It's a plunder even. There's simply some rear troops plundering around. And this gives you a great loss of loyalty, yeah. Sure. But you will get supplies. Yeah, Scorched Earth is also a thing here. It was a brutal war. Those wars back. I mean, all wars are brutal, but they were ravaging there left and right. I was rather play Hearts and Minds. Check here, there is an overlay for loyalty. Wasn't there? Here. Wait, let's get rid of... Okay, that is overlapped by this here. I mean, we can hover over here. Yeah, 55. I was here at York. Some Hearts and Minds. And what is Swiss London? Northampton is also quite... London looks not too bad, but it's quite important. But that was the only one. Yeah, 35% landmine. Might provide a breach in a besieged fort. Yeah, that is nice. Did we order it? Yeah. Play over a besieged enemy city. But it seems like we're not fulfilling the requirements. Yeah, nice cards. Really like this, yeah. This provides you some historical flavor. And you don't feel so detached. You see the Scorched Earth plundering. And then you are back in town and know you're fighting here a war and not some... And get some idea what was going on there. Good, that is enough for cards. Let's quickly check the strategic atlas. You see, now it's quite more armies. Yeah, that is quite a lot of armies even. Didn't even identify most of them. But if they're sitting in town, you need really check those towns. You can move outside and you can move inside a town. And you see, if they're sitting inside, you don't see them always. I think there's a button somewhere where you can make highlight all armies or all units come up into your interface. So you don't miss them out. I mean, most of them are probably defending, yeah, because this army planner is showing you basically every infantry unit that is sitting around somewhere. But still, always click on those towns and check out what is going on. Garrison units here. Yeah. I think there was a button or a hotkey. If you press that, everybody comes up. Like this guy here. Yeah, most of those units are... Bigger armies always show up like this. Commanded armies always... No, perhaps not. Ah, here, yeah, fleet. Show you some fleet movement. Is there anything here? Those loyalists here at Lancaster. First, you want to sail into the Irish Sea and check out what is going on there. You don't even need to sail that far. Here is Exeter with a port. Sail over there. And let's put in our offensive posture. But we need to watch out, yeah, that is basically marked. Make those ships quite aggressive and they might get bombarded from the coast. Good. Yeah, familiarize yourself in the beginning with your force, check it out, take your time. But I think those HOD games, the longer you play them, the more they grow on you. From the interface-wise and from the usability. No one did map and unit art like HOD did during the peak. Beautiful game. That is true, that is... And I think that is probably the best game when it comes to English Civil War. At least on an operational strategic scale. I mean, what is there? There's of course games that focus on this topic, but I mean really in a serious manner. Good, what is this guy here doing? Oh, he's a loyalist, okay. And he is besieging me currently. And those guys, okay, this is... But we soon should become... No, this is us, a loyalist. Here we have some small army, but that is not enough, I guess. What is... But he is us only with one... We don't know exactly. What is he running? 4 units. Okay, it's not the biggest. But this guy here, that is huge. This here, we need to watch out for this army. Boarding. Okay. Yeah, you guys need to hold out. Nothing we can do right now. Only have garrisons here. We are currently occupied here in the center in the north. Artop's force, but you're without commander. Okay. Yeah, we might get one guy out here. I really have no commander here. No. Here. You command this army. This. Need to watch out, yeah, but should be fine. Look at how easy that is. So, tell me, show me another war game. But it's that easy. Not to find. Okay. Good, capital is currently London. Let's do the turn. Ah, great. So we have combat. Ah, wait, what is it? Ah, because he was, that is the siege. Yeah, we have, that was the siege, right? Right, I need to quickly check out the sides. That is the enemies. Yeah, okay, they came with a quite strong force and engaged us. Yeah, that is a battle screen. And really like the detail, you see what is influencing the battle, everything, every unit you can hover over. And every value. And what deployment they chose. And here you see even the rounds. Nobody has even a very detailed screen, but I think that is already mixed in here. Looking for the super detailed. It's not really that important, but just to show you the what's going into this game. But I think it is already incorporated in this screen. There's normally a button in many HOD games, detailed battle report. But here you can also check out, first round. Then here, in the first combat round, what bonuses applied to those units. Our deadly fire ravaged the enemy ranks. So this every battle is telling a story, and that's, I think, how you need to do a war game. Yeah, we talked about this in War in the Pacific, Gary Grigsby, a game that is super huge. You might, a day, I don't know, hundreds of aircraft might get destroyed. But every aircraft is represented, you know, in this battle. And you don't need to dive into that deep, into those battle reports or whatever. But if you want to find some single pilot somewhere going MIA or whatever, you will find him. And can check every combat report like a true commander. Go into the detail and see what happened there. And yeah, alone that this detail is present is already quite exciting. Yeah, there was somewhere in the north. Those guys retreated, it seems. And we arrived here and will now conduct the siege. Good, yeah, 15 days have passed. Skippon arrived here. And is now commander of the new force here. And might help. Those guys are quite strong. And the walls are besieged, so he is currently sieging. But he switched back from the aggressive. You see the commander on its own decided, I mean, we can see what happens if I do it again. But perhaps he decided that is madness. Go, is arrive and do immediately an all-out attack on the walls. That is rather madness. Yeah. Here, Poynitz, a new leader available. Yeah, let's see if we can play this card here. This Breach the Wall card. Oh, we can. Look at this. We can conduct... Did we manage the Breach? No, I think the Breach failed. I remember we played last turn the Breach card. But we can now try a Storm attack. I don't think it will work out. But just in order to show it to you, and same we can basically do here, right? Yeah. Show you some brutal combat. But we might try to breach the wall with a landmine. Which means they will, I guess, try to dig below the walls. And perhaps we want to reinforce the walls in the south. This guy's coming in here. Should we? Oh, too late. Okay, we can't do that. But we could scorch the earth. Yeah, they sometimes did that. Scorch the earth in the vicinity in order to not allow a sieging army to live easily there. We might do that. Which of course is absolutely hurting the local population. Yeah, you might starve them. But that's why I like those cards. Yeah, they will show you sometimes those tough decisions or also simply those absolute brutal decisions that were conducted in war. But you can also improve the defense here. So let's scorch the earth. So I think seems like those guys left. I mean, they were besieging us and currently are not besieging us anymore. But now it's too late, what? Nah, you can remove it with right click. I don't know what they're planning currently. They're roaming around. Perhaps those ships did something to them. You see, we are blockading them currently here. With our small fleet. Could also... But there's a transport squadron. Perhaps those guys should go back home. Transport squadron, I don't know, can they fight? I mean, they have ammo. What can sell can fight. And yeah, you can move. That is also something very unique in this game. You can position your units how you want. There's no difference if you position it. I mean, there is a difference, of course, if you do what I did now. But you can sort them on your own. That is also very unique. Never seen it in another game. in small regions, then it, here you won't have the problem, but there are sometimes HOD games where you have very small regions, perhaps something like this, and then you're sitting there with an army of Doom, then you might have trouble to keep them apart. But usually that is not a problem. I mean, basically, I saw all war games, played all war games, and I've from a educated opinion, can say that this is HOD is rather on the higher level of good interfaces. But sure, if somebody on a Steam store first time hits a game like this, coming from Player Unknown's Battlegrounds. And it is of course quite a change of okay. What? Yeah, it will show you the siege, and then you basically saw everything. For this, we will do another turn. Yeah, it seems like the siege didn't happen. Guess we are simply too weak. But, I mean, it was a besieged, yeah, but all-out attack. Those cards are not 100% cards. They won't trigger. You might try. This is structure intact. Yeah. Could be that they assaulted and failed, period, quickly. If you check those values of those guys, this one is Levy infantry. What you're supposed to do with them? That's not some Spartans or whatever. Oh yeah, Scottish infantry. Yeah, that doesn't make a difference. I think ender structure also doesn't make sense. That is only if you have a town or something that is belonging to you that is not doing anything for siege. They are simply not ready to conduct the siege. Yeah, look at this. But we immediately failed, yeah. I mean, look, yeah, that is... not a way to this. It's again somewhere here in the north. It's generally here taking another region. Okay, Birmingham is fine. Ah, that is good. This time there might be a 35% chance for 2 turns. Create a breach. I mean, that is, I guess, also a problem. We're standing in front of the walls. We first need some sort of a breach or something. We also don't have any artillery weapons with us, which might be simply important in order to create at least some sort of opportunity to... Ah, here, partially breached. Okay, those guys managed a breach. And perhaps... But currently it seems like this army is not ready to conduct a... And you don't need to do it, yeah, it's simply... I just wanted to show you a siege, but... It's not happening, not happening. Historical sieges were not some... You arrive and immediately storm those things, it was... Quite a... tedious affair. Here, okay, here this guy is ravaging. Captured Inverness. Okay, whatever, you should get an idea of this game. I can highly recommend it if you have any, even if you're not that much into the English Civil War. You might simply play it because it provides you with this very compact AO and which is a good game to experience grand strategy. Okay, one more game I will come up. Something entirely different. This was here rather something you can overlook. Now it will come with a game, yeah. Starts with